corned beef and cabbage has to be like top 10 most comforting foods, right? I'm going to show you how to make it from scratch, from start to finish, brining it, cooking it. We're going to add in all the good vegetables. I promise you, you're going to love this recipe. The history of corned beef and cabbage is absolutely fascinating, and I promise it's probably way different than you may have thought. If you get a chance, definitely research it. It's so cool to find out how this came to be. Well, we've got a 7-day brine ahead of us, which means we got to start right now. Sound good? Let's cook. We're going to begin by making that homemade pickling spice. I've got some allspice berries I'm going to add to a bowl. Next, some bay leaves, followed up with a cracked cinnamon stick. Next, some cloves, followed up with some mustard seeds, then some ground ginger. Going to add in some coriander seeds. Next, some black peppercorns, and then some crushed red pepper flakes. Now I'm just going to grab a fork or a spoon if you have it, no problem, and just sort of mash everything together, get those ingredients infused. You can absolutely make this homemade pickling spice with a pestle and mortar. Okay, fine. You don't already have a lot of these ingredients in your spice cabinet, or you don't want to go out and buy them. They obviously make pickling spice that's already pre-made. You can absolutely use this in this recipe. Now, we are going to add some cold water to a very large pot that's on the cooktop, followed up by adding in some packed light brown sugar. Next, we're going to add in some sea salt. And then an important ingredient, we have some number one pink curing salt, also known as Prague powder. We are simply going to sprinkle that in with the brown sugar and gallon of water in the pot. Let me stop really quick and say this. No, you do not have to use pink curing salt. I do recommend it though. It will help flavor up your meat. It will help make it that nice red color that you see when you order corned beef. And it also aids in preserving meat for these long brines, these 5, 7, 10 day long brines. So my recommendation is to use it, but you don't have to. Here's what we do next. We're gonna add in some, but not all, of the pickling spice. We're gonna crank the heat on to high. And what I like to do after a few minutes is just come in with a whisk and make sure everything is completely combined. And really, once it comes to a boil, we know the salts and sugars have been dissolved. So I'm gonna go over and transfer it to a bigger pot because the brisket I have is a little bit big. I'll show you in a second. And then what I like to do is add in about a 1/2 gallon of ice cubes to help cool this down. Now, for some reason, if the ice cubes do not completely cool the liquid, my recommendation is wait till it gets to at least room temperature. Or if you want, if you got a big freezer or refrigerator, you can flash cool it in there. It'll only take about 20 or 30 minutes. Now, we're gonna pull that brisket right out of the refrigerator. This is about a 6-pound brisket. This does not include the point, so it's simply known as a flat brisket. For this recipe, it will work for anywhere in between a 4- and 7-pound brisket. Now what we wanna do is take it and transfer it right over to the cooled brine. We are gonna press it down in there, and to ensure that our brisket stays underneath, what I like to do is add a few glass plates or bowls. What this will do is completely submerge it. Now we're going to the refrigerator. So now you got 7 days. Now what? You need to go back every 2 days or so, move those plates around, move the brisket around, make sure every little square centimeter has the opportunity to touch that brine. It's very important that you do that. Now my brine is for a 5 to 7 day brine. That's why I have a little bit of extra salt in there. Oftentimes you may see online that a corned beef takes 10 days, yet you can absolutely do a 10 day brine if you want. I don't think you need it. So after that 7 days, let's come back and check it out. Here we go. Let's take that brined brisket right out of the refrigerator, set it down, looking really good. What we want to do to begin is remove all of those plates, of course, and they can be a little heavy, so be careful taking those out. Obviously, they're going straight to the dishwasher. And now we are going to take that brisket out of the brine. It looks really good. We're heading right over to a clean sink, and we're just going to rinse it very thoroughly with cold water. What this does is get off any of the spices that have stuck, or if there's any salt crusted on in any areas, which there shouldn't be, but just in case, we want to rinse it off because it is going to be very salty at this point. Now we're going straight over to the cutting board. Let's have a look. It's not overly appetizing, but this is purely to show you what it will look like at this stage after it's been brining for 7 days. Now, because this brisket is pretty big, what I'm going to do is slice it in half right down the middle just to make sure it all fits in one pot. Now go ahead and add it to a large pot. I'm using the same one, but of course I washed it first. And now what you want to do is fill it up with cold water. We want to fill it up until it's about 4 inches over the top of the beef. So now we're heading back over to our cooktop, and I'm going to add in a little bit more of that pickling spice. Remember I told you, don't use all of it. And then what you simply want to do is mix all those things together, and then we are going to crank the heat on high because we want to bring it to a boil. Okay, at the end of the day, if you're watching this video and you're like, Chef Billy Parisi, you are nuts. I'm not curing my own brisket. That is way too insane, takes way too much time. I don't have the refrigerator space, whatever the case may be. I get it. But I'm pretty sure they are selling corned beef at your local grocery stores probably all year round. You can absolutely go get one of those with a little spice packet and do the exact same process of cooking it in water. Okay, I think this will taste way better than that store-bought one, but if you can't do it, fine. Here's what we do now. After about 20 minutes or so, I'm going to come back and take a look, and yep, it is boiling. Everything looks fantastic. We're now going to turn the heat down to low, a little bit more than that maybe, and we're going to cook it for about 3.5 to 4 hours on low heat, and it looks and smells amazing right now. Let me stop really quick and say, if for some reason you want to keep that brisket really long, you don't want to slice it in half like I did before I put it in the water and cooked in the pot, or you don't have a pot even big enough for that, the other option that you do have, and it's something we used to do back at this country club I worked in, is we would put that big old brisket in a hotel pan that's about 6 inches deep. It's known as a 600 hotel pan. You could probably pick it up from your local restaurant depot store. And we would wrap it in foil, put water in there obviously, and cook it at 300 degrees for about 4.5 to 5 hours. The other option, of course, is the slow cooker. And you put your corned beef in there with water, you cook it on low for about 8 hours. And after 3 hours, what you do is you come in and you add all of your vegetables to cook it the rest of the way. Well, now I've got about 45 minutes or so until my corned beef is done. So we're gonna get started to prepping vegetables. Here we go. Starting off with some green cabbage. You could also use Savoy cabbage here. So go ahead and slice it in half. And then what I'm going to do is slice out that core. You could actually leave it in there. It does actually tenderize up a bit when cooking it. And then what I'm going to do is slice it into wedges each half. I'm going to use one whole head of cabbage for this recipe. And then the next thing I have, of course, is some carrots. We are going to peel those on all sides and then cut them to 1 to 1.5 inches thick. This looks absolutely perfect. We are going over to our corned beef pot with about 30 total minutes left in the cooking process. We're going to add in some carrots. And next, I have some red potatoes and Yukon potatoes. I just happen to have both. Feel free to use one or the other. I just want to kind of use these up, and either of them would be pretty classic in this recipe. What we're going to do is add a lid to this. Since I don't have one, a large saute pan will do, and we're going to cook it for about 15 to 20 minutes. Then we are going to come back, take the lid off. We're going to add all of that sliced up cabbage that we prepared. And if you have to move things around to make it fit, please be my guest. You can see this is bursting out of the top, but there's way more room than I'm showing here. Just need to move some things around and push it down. Add the top on. We're going to cook it for another 10 to 15 minutes. Get that cabbage nice and softened up. Let's have a look. Absolutely fantastic. Smells amazing in here. So at this point, what we are going to do is start to prep everything up for serving. So go ahead and remove it from the cooktop over to the countertop. And what we're going to do is start by slicing the brisket. Now we want to go against the grain. You see how the grain threads kind of run this way? Well, we're going to slice it against the grain that way. But because this is big, I'm going to slice it in half first, turn it, and then slice it about 1/2 to 3/4 inches thick. I like a little bit thicker brisket. You can, of course, go thin. It's completely up to you, but you definitely have to cut off the end and try some before you serve it. And I don't know about you, but we used to eat corned beef and cabbage pretty much every St. Paddy's Day, so the smells, now that it's finished, are bringing back so many great memories. And it's just like I tell you every week, once you start understanding these fundamental cooking techniques and you practice them over and over again, your food is going to be so good. I mean, we just made a homemade corned beef from scratch. The brine, the cooking, everything. You do this, I'm telling you, you are going to love the flavors. And again, putting all these techniques into practice, your food is going to be out of this world. And like I always say, homemade food from scratch always tastes better. So now let's plate up in slow-mo. I'm going to serve this on a cutting board. If you have a large platter, fine. Starting with the cabbage, next some of the sliced beef corn brisket. And of course, I've got those cooked carrots followed up with some of the potatoes. You could also serve some mustard on the side for the corned beef. That's really tasty. And then finish it off with a little chopped parsley. Give it some nice green color. And my oh my, check out this beauty. It just doesn't get any better than this. The flavors, oh my gosh, you'll never get that thing from the store again if you're willing to do this. Be sure to subscribe to my channel, like and share this video, and check out this video right here. I made it just for you. I promise you, you'll love it. We'll see you on there.